begin our session today. So good morning everyone. We were discussing about active and passive voice declarative sentence. Okay, how to change all the tense forms out of 12 tense forms. You have to know that only 8 forms can be changed into passive, right? So yes, all these sentences are declarative sentence, and also it has a verb, it has a finite verb in it, and according to the tenses you are able to convert one single sentence into the other forms also. And you know that there is no passive form for present perfect continuous, past perfect continuous, future continuous, and future perfect continuous. So you know that all these sentences are given in declarative sentence. We have learned many types of kinds of sentences, right? We know there are declarative sentence, there are imperatives, there are interrogatives, and today my intention is to teach you a sentence, how to change an imperative sentence into its passive form. Okay, so before starting imperatives, let me ask you a question. Are you thorough with the changing of active voice to passive voice, children?
Yes, ma'am.
You know how to change it and all the tense forms also?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
And according to rule or according to the grammarians, only 8 out of 12 forms can be changed or can be turned into passive voice form. There is no passive voice. Let me repeat. There is no passive voice form for present perfect continuous, past perfect continuous, future continuous, and future perfect continuous, as it has some limitations. Okay. So my dear children, now today I am going to teach you how an imperative sentence can be changed into its passive form. Okay. So let me ask you another question. What are called the imperative sentences in English grammar? I know that you are all thorough with the imperative sentence, but still I just want to know what are called imperative sentences in English grammar.
Yes, Ashish, it is
a type of sentence which actually expresses a command, request, order, prohibition. Okay, so there are, can you give me a few examples for an imperative sentence?
Ma'am, go there.
Go away. Okay, go away.
Shut the door.
Shut the door. Excellent.
Come here.
Come here. Okay, fine.
Please give me a pen.
Please give me a pen. Absolutely right.
Do not do it.
Don't do this. Okay, fine. Excellent. And these are a few examples for an imperative sentence. And you have noticed that how can we distinguish a sentence from an imperative sentence from a declarative sentence? As I have told you, there is a word order pattern for declarative sentence. A declarative sentence is always starting with a subject followed by a verb, and it has an object at the end. And this is the word order pattern for a declarative sentence. But this is different in imperative. Right? An imperative sentence, it is in the form of a request, it can be an order, but it is not starting with the subject exactly, right? But it has a subject, right? A hidden subject is there in an imperative sentence. Can you tell me the subject of an imperative sentence?
You.
So instead of shut up, there you can see a subject which is hiding behind the bars, you, right? Instead of you shut up, we can use shut up. Instead of you come here, I can say come here. Instead of go, you please go and open the door, I can say please open the door, right? So it is understood that there is a subject called you in it. So the subject of an imperative sentence is you. By looking at your face, why I have to point, you go, you do, you take, it is not needed. Okay, so here in an imperative sentence, it is easy to identify from a declarative sentence because imperatives normally or generally starting with a verb, isn't it?
Yes.
Isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So, tell me the subject of an imperative sentence.
You.
I have a doubt. According to the rule, active and passive voice, I have told you 3 points to remember, right? Before changing one sentence from active voice to the passive voice, the first step is to identify the verb of the sentence, okay? Once it is identified, then you know this verb is in finite verb form or it is in the form of B plus past participle form. If it takes the form of B plus past participle form, it is clear that that sentence is given in passive form. If it has a finite verb, it is clear that it is an active voice form. Am I correct?
Yes, ma'am.
But
yes,
according ma'am. to the imperative, or according to the grammarians, an imperative sentence does not start with a subject. And we actually I have told you an imperative sentence in active voice, the subject is predominant and the object is taking in the position. Once we transform or once we change the sentence from active to passive, the object of the sentence becomes the subject and subject goes to the place of object. But here the subject you is hiding behind the bird. So how can we change an imperative sentence into imperative, I mean active and passive voice? Okay, active imperative sentence into passive voice. Okay, that is what we are going to learn today. Yes,
ma'am. Like, are warnings imperative sentences?
Yes,
giving warnings.
Give me an example, Smriti.
Ma'am, like,
prohibition. Prohibition. What is prohibition? We are preventing someone to do something, right?
Yes, ma'am.
We are stopping him to do something, right? So to an extent, this prohibition is equal to a warning, right? Don't go there. Don't go there. It's a warning. If you go there, something bad happens to you, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So it can be an imperative. Okay. So my dear children, listen carefully. We are going to learn. So we need to learn two rules. Okay, children, we need to learn two rules. And this using this, what is the plural form of the formula? We have learned formula a word. Can you tell me the plural word for formula?
Ma'am, formula.
Formulas.
Formulas. Okay, accepted, but it is not right. So I am giving you a chance to search for the plural form of formula. Have you heard of formulae?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, that is the plural form for formula. Okay, so find it. Find it, and formulas are not wrong. Okay, formulas are not wrong, but actually the usage is formulae. There is no word formulas. So find out the right plural form for formula today itself, after the soon after ending this class. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
So we have two formulae, and I am going to introduce these two formulae for converting an imperative sentence into passive. Okay, let me introduce those formulae. And the first formula is, see, children, look at the board. Imperative passive form. I request everyone to write the rule in a paper. Heading, imperative passive. If you are getting a sentence, and especially if it is an imperative sentence, where you can see the sentence is normally starting with the verb, shut the door. You know that the word you is the subject of an imperative sentence, which cannot be seen here, right? It is hiding somewhere, okay? So the formula to construct or to transform an imperative sentence from active to passive voice, this is only one formula. We have two formulae, and this one is only one. First formula, you can start your sentence with you are plus, and just look at the sentence and imagine, or just to understand whether the sentence is in the form of a request or it is just a question, or not a question, if it is in the form of just telling something, just speaking something, or if it is in the form of an order, or it can be a command, it can be a begging, or it may be an advice. Okay, so according to the sentence, you can write here after you are. It can be you are requested, or you are asked, or you are told, or you are ordered, you are begged, you are commanded, you are advised to shut the door. And here, object. Okay, you write, just add object there also at the end. I request everybody to copy this rule. Once again, you are plus. Write a plus here, and after verb you write object here.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, so when we change imperative to passive form, right, we should always start with you are.
Not always, not always. According to this formula, you can begin your sentence with you are. See, yes. You are. See, shut the door. You are plus ordered to shut. the door, the object, right? So here you is the subject, the door is the object. Agree? Shut yes, is the verb. Agree?
Yes, ma'am.
So when you change an imperative sentence into its passive form, formula number one, you can use this formula if the object is clear there. You know, here we have an object. Okay, shut the door. The object is the door. If the object is very clear, you can use this formula here. Okay, there are two formulae. Any one of the formula according to the situation that you can use. Okay, the second formula is a little lighter than this formula. But yes.
Ma'am, so when writing, when turning an imperative sentence into a passive, into its passive form, in that case also should we use the past participle form of the verb?
See, look at here, which form I have used here? Which form I have used here? Have I used any past participle form here?
No, ma'am.
I have used. I have used. Ordered. You are requested. Ordered. Asked, told, ordered, begged, commanded, advised, 2+shut. 2+shut is not the verb form, right? What is it? It is the two infinitive form, isn't it? Two infinitive form.
Non-finite form.
Ah, infinitive form. It is actually called the two infinitive form. Okay, so you are ordered. See, look at here. So are ordered. B+past participle form. Isn't it, Smriti?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So your question, it was a nice question. It was a very good question. Thank you.
Ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, so this is formula number one. So I request Ananda Krishnan to repeat the formula. First formula to convert one imperative sentence into passive. I have told you there are two formulas, right? I'm not using formulas, two formulae. And among the two, I have started with the first one. And that also that you should, you are already clear that the subject of an imperative sentence is you. So you can start your imperative sentence in its passive form, starting with the you plus after you, only R is possible, right? We cannot use is. Okay, so you are ordered or
requested or
asked, told, or advised, begged, all these words. So I request Ananda Krishnan to read the formula once again, the complete formula.
Yes, ma'am. Formula one, you are plus requested or asked or told or ordered or begged or commanded or advised plus two plus verb plus the object.
Very good. You got it now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I request Nihal Mustafa to read the rule once again.
You plus are plus requested or asked or told or ordered or begged or commanded or advised plus who plus verb plus the object.
2+base form. Okay, 2+base form plus the object. This must be used. Okay, so I have a question for you. You please write the example also. Shut the door. Have you completed the example of shut the door?
Yes, ma'am.
Shut the door. So how to change that sentence using this formula?
You are ordered to
shut the door.
Okay. So next question. One more. Get out of my home or house. Get out of my house. So remember, before changing one sentence from active voice to passive voice, remember which kind of sentence it is in. Whether it is an imperative sentence or a declarative sentence. Declarative, you please think about the tenses also. Which tense form, which finite verb it is used in, and you have learned three boxes how to change one sentence or one tense form into its passive form, right? Or if the question is not like that, if the question is an imperative question, active voice, so you can use two formulas there, two rules there, and out of these two rules, first one you have learned just now. So here comes your second example. Get out of my house. Get out of my house. What is actually the style of talking?
Ma'am, it is an order or a command.
It is a command. Okay, it is a command or an order. Excellent. So how you are going to construct the sentence?
Ma'am, you are commanded to get out of my house.
I have a request, children. Then commanding, this can be an order, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So change it. Tell me.
You are ordered to get out from my house.
Excellent. You are ordered to get out of my house. You are ordered to get out of my house. Okay? Have you all got this answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes.
Next question. Be careful. Be careful. What is it? It is an imperative sentence.
Ma'am, advice.
So how you are going to construct its answer? Passive voice.
Ma'am, you are advised.
Okay, I request any one person to give me this answer. Geetika Manoj, how you are going to construct the sentence into its passive form?
Ma'am, you are advised to be careful.
To be careful. Excellent. To be careful. Okay, you are advised to be careful. Please stand up from my seat. Please stand up from my seat. Please don't shout, all of you. I'll ask one particular person.
Can you repeat the question?
Yes, of course. Please stand up from my seat.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome. Okay, so I have, who is ready? Okay. Anna. Yes, Anna.
Ma'am, you are requested to stand up from my seat.
Excellent. You are requested to stand up from my seat. Imperative, passive. Okay, next question. Next question. Get up early. Get up early. Who is ready? Who is ready?
Ma'am.
Ma'am.
Yes, Priti.
Ma'am, you are asked to get up early.
Fine. Any other option? Very good. Very good. Any other option?
You are advised to get up early.
Okay, excellent. Any other option?
Ma'am.
You are told.
Very good. Very good. You are told. So you can use any of these words from the list, okay? According to the situation, according to the sentence, okay? Okay, if it is a request, use only request. Okay, next one. Help the poor. P-O-O-R. Help the poor. P-O-O-R. Ananya. Ananya K. Vijesh.
Yes, ma'am.
Help the poor.
Help the poor.
Can you change the sentence from active voice to passive voice? First of all, look at the kind of sentence. It is an imperative sentence starting with the verb help. And you know there is a subject you is hiding somewhere. We don't know where it is, but it is hiding somewhere. Okay. And you can use formula one here to change or to transform this active voice sentence into passive voice. So how?
Altina? Can you repeat the sentence?
The sentence is help the poor. It is easy. Okay, Sravana. Sravana.
Ma'am, you are requested to help the poor.
Okay, that is fine. Any other option? Any other answer?
You are told to help the poor.
Okay. Nothing wrong in it.
You are advised.
It can be an advice, right? Or it can be a request. You are advised. Help the poor. It's an advice.
It can be an advice from an older person.
Yes. Yes, elder person. Yes.
Ma'am, so we can write any of these, right?
Any of those. Nothing wrong in it.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so next question. Leave the room at once. Leave the room at once.
Ma'am, can you repeat?
Leave, L-E-A-V-E, leave the room at once. Yes, Devika?
You are ordered to leave the room at once.
Excellent. You are ordered to leave the room at once. Fine. Excellent. So these are the examples for imperative, passive under formula 1 or under rule number 1. And I have told you there is one more formula which is very lighter than this one. Okay. This is easy also. Okay. Let me introduce formula or the rule 2 for you to change an imperative sentence from active voice to passive voice. Yes, Anantu? I think you have something to say.
Yes, ma'am. Can you give an example for the word commanded?
Commanded?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Bring it.
Bring it. So if it's like that, we can write it as a order also, right?
No problem. No, that is why I have told you can actually use in the form of ordering also. So order and command are the same, right? Order and command are the same, but commanding, raise the flag. Raise the flag. It's a command. It normally also, yes, someone is actually coming.
Professional form.
Yes, especially soldiers. The superior officers used to give commands. Command. Salute. It's a command. Salute the nation. It can be a command. And you know that the leaders of some particular parade and all, they are commanding. And ordering, they are commanding, right? Give a proper command to the officers, junior officers. Okay, that is the only small difference between a command and an order. And let me introduce the second formula, rule number 2, how to change an imperative sentence into passive form. Okay, we just discussed about rule number 1, to change an imperative sentence passive form to the active form to the passive form using for rule number 1. At the same time, I have told you there is one more formula. I am going to introduce that formula to you. Okay, children, look at here, formula number 2. See, imperative sentence. How to change an imperative sentence from active voice to passive voice? Okay, just look at the board, children. We can change our active voice if the active voice is in the form of an imperative sentence. See, we discussed formula number 1 here. That is, you are. You can change one sentence from active imperative to passive imperative using you are plus requested, asked, or told, ordered, begged, commanded, advised, and 2 plus verb form, infinitive form plus object. This is what we discussed a few minutes before. And now, let me introduce for, I have told there is one more rule. Okay, easy. This is much more easy comparing with the first one, right? Look at here. It is easy to change an imperative sentence active into its passive form using this formula. Look at the board, children. You should speak in your passive voice sentence. If the active voice sentence is given in imperative form, you can use the second formula also. Okay, two formulae, and this one is actually starting with let. Let plus object plus be plus past participle form of the verb. Okay, look at here. Look at here. I am going to introduce the rule number 2 to change an imperative sentence into its passive form. Example, as you all know, as I have told, what is the subject of an imperative sentence?
It is
not seen here, it is hiding, okay, but still the subject is you here. I'm just removing it, and I started my imperative sentence with the verb form, and you can see the object here, okay, the car. So how to use the second rule here, how to apply rule number 2 here? I should begin my sentence with the let plus, you know, I have told you, you is the subject of an imperative sentence. And what is the object here? We got the subject,
the car,
the verb and the object. Okay, excellent. So the car is the object, and I should use be plus past participle form of the verb. What is the verb here? Park. Okay, so my sentence after changing into imperative passive, I have got like this. Let the car be parked. Okay. Which one is easy, children? Imperative rule number one or rule number two is easy for you?
Number one.
Okay, excellent. Some said, okay, excellent. Okay, let us try with the second rule, okay? So let me introduce a few questions for you. Sing a song. Don't shout with your answer. I know that you're thorough now, but still please don't raise a window. I don't want mass answers. I'll ask one person.
Can you please repeat the question?
Yes. Sing a song. The question is, sing a song. Don't use the first rule now. You can use the second rule now. As I have introduced the second rule to you, this is the chance for you to use the second rule.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, you are excused always, my dear.
When it's asked to change, it's not clear.
Ananya, your voice is breaking and the voice was not clear for me also. It was not clear. Could you please repeat?
When the imperative sentence is asked to change active to passive form, you can use the both rules. Any rule?
It's not clear. What she did you hear what she said?
She's asking.
Ashish, could you please repeat her question?
Ma'am, I think she's telling.
Well, if there is object, you can use the first formula. Okay. Okay, and also you can use the second formula also. Both two formulas can be used according to the sentence. Sometimes, like I have told you, the second one, for example, some sentences get up. There is no subject, right? Object, right?
Yes,
get up. So which one is possible there? Which formula is suitable there? Can we use both the formulas? Because in the second rule, I have not told you to use object. But get up, there is no object used in it. So which formula can we use?
First formula.
If there is object, it is easy for us to set with the second rule or to apply the rule two. But at the same time, if the object is not given, you can use the first one. You can prefer. Second one, okay? According to your, thinking, you please use it. Okay? So, here the sentence is sing a song. Okay? Sing a song. Namasya, I need your help. Namasya, please tell me how to change the sentence into passive form using rule number two. You know, remember, it should be an imperative sentence. When you get a sentence for converting from active voice to passive voice, remember, If the sentence is in any one of the 12 tense forms, I have taught you the three boxes, right? According to that, you can use it. But if the sentence is imperative, we have two formulas to convert that active sentence imperative into passive form. So look at the sentence, sing a song.
Sing a song.
Yes.
Ma'am. Yeah. Ma'am, let the song be sung.
Very good. Very good, Smriti. Very good. Let the song. Let plus... A song plus
B plus
past participle form of the verb sing is
sung.
Present form sang past form sung past sung. Participle form. Excellent. Thank you, Smriti. Another question again, as Namasya has not responded. So this question to Namasya again. Okay, all others please keep quiet for a moment. Okay. Namasya, question for you. Can you hear me, Namasya?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, question is for you now. Speak the truth. Speak the truth. Remember, past participle form of the verb must be used. You have the formula now, starting with the letter. Repeat the rule number two. Namasya, can you repeat rule two?
Let plus object plus B plus past participle form of a verb.
So you have got the rule. Okay. Now change the sentence from active voice to the passive voice using rule number two.
Let the truth be thinking
about the past participle form of the verb. Repeat, what is the present form of the verb speak?
Spoke.
Is that spoke?
No, ma'am.
Speak.
Spoken.
So speak, spoke, spoken. So how to end your sentence, Namasya?
Let the song, let the truth be spoken.
Excellent. Okay, let the truth be spoken. So one thing, you should be familiar with all the four forms, okay? A verb has a four form. It has a present form, it has a past form, it has a past participle form and a present participle form. So in active and passive voice, which form is normally using? We are using the past participle form of a verb. So you should be thorough with the past participle form of the verbs, okay? Now, another question. Turn off the television. Turn off the television. Okay? Turn off the television. Please don't give me the answer. I'll ask one person. Turn off the television. Siyan Fatima? Siyan?
Yes,
change this active voice sentence into passive voice. Remember, example is an imperative form. Imperative sentence. Okay, so we have two choices. Either we can use the first formula or we can use the second one. So here we have an object. So which formula can be used here? It is easy to use the second rule. Okay,
second,
so tell me if you're using first rule also, don't, there is no problem for that. Okay, but use, okay, as we are learning rule two now, you use rule two now to me.
Let the television be turned off.
Excellent. Let the television be turned off. Excellent. Very good. Very good. Next question.
Thank you, ma'am.
Complete the work. Emil, this question is for you. All of you write the question. Complete the work. Change imperative active voice sentence into its passive form. Complete
okay,
the work. Ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Let the work be completed.
Very good. Let the work be completed. Fine. Another question. Learn your lessons. Learn your lesson. Learn your lesson. No, I am moving to Harriet and Xavier now. Harriet, write the question. Write the question. Learn your lesson. Over? Okay. Tell me the answer. Unmute.
Let the lesson be learned.
Spelling of learned.
L-E-A-R-N-E-D.
Okay. We can use E-D and also T. Okay. L-E-A-R-N-T. Past participle form. Okay, like spent. Yeah. S-P-E-N-T is the past form and past participle form of S-P-E-N-D.
Okay. And both are the same, right?
Ah. So children, another question for you. Revise your book. Aaron Anthony, revise your book. Aaron, revise your book.
Let the book be revised.
Very good. Let the book be revised. One more question. One more question. Clean your room. Question two. Abhyuday George. Clean your room. Abhyuday George.
Yes, ma'am. Let the room be cleaned.
Could you please speak a little louder?
Let the room be cleaned.
Cleaned. Past participle form, right? Fine. Very good. Very good. Let the room be cleaned. Fine. Excellent. Very good. Okay. Next question. I thought to ask this to Nihal Mustafa. Nihal, kill the snake.
Let the snake be killed.
Very good. Let the snake be killed. Okay. And the last question. Here, I'm giving you a chance for you to use any of the formula. Okay, I'm not specifically mentioning use second formula. This question, punish him. Punish him. You can use either formula one or formula two. As you are using Google form, this time for writing your examination. So remember the options given there. Okay.
Could you please repeat the sentence?
The sentence is punish him.
Thank you, ma'am.
Punish him. Yes, Ravana.
Let him be punished.
Let
him.
Ma'am, let he be punished. Let he be punished.
Subject plus object plus. So she said the right answer. I was not clear then. That is why I just paused for a moment. So I would like to hear it from others. How you have? Yes, Anandu.
Ma'am, you are ordered to punish him.
You are ordered to punish. Him. Okay, both the answers are correct. Okay, so this is, I have 5 more minutes. So I have 1 more topic to introduce. I don't know whether it is difficult for you to follow today. So let me have a recap of what I have taught you today. Just look at the board. Let us share formula 1 and formula 2 now. Once again, imperative sentences. As you all know, an imperative sentence is a sentence which is actually in the form of an order. It is in the order of a command. It is in the order of prohibition. Or to prevent something in the form of an advice. Okay, and this is called the second kind of sentence, and this is also an imperative sentence. Is a simple sentence for you all. And one more thing, you know, the subject of an imperative sentence is always you. And the third point, I have introduced 2 formulas, formula 1 and formula 2. What is formula number 1, Aaron Anthony?
You are plus requested plus asked or told or ordered or begged or commanded or advised plus to plus the.
Okay, example.
You are ordered to get out of my house.
You are ordered to
get out of my house.
Get out of the house. Okay, what is formula number 2? That is, let me ask this question to no person here. Kanish, what is formula number 2 or rule 2 to change an imperative sentence from active voice to passive form?
Let plus object plus be plus past participle form of the verb.
Could you please repeat?
Let plus object plus be plus past participle form of the verb. Plus object.
Object. Okay. Example.
Let the truth be spoken.
Okay, excellent. So these are the 2 topics we covered about this active and passive voice. As you all know, we have completed declarative sentences with the tense forms, and also we have completed imperative sentences with tense form. I have a request. Try to get more number of 10 sentences in imperative and its passive form. Okay, and it should be ready in your grammar note also. Thank you so much for attending the class, and I'll come with a new topic in the sense active and passive voice, another kind of sentence in the coming class. Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. We'll meet you.